Hello, I am Test Drive, and welcome to an episode of Forza Motorsport 4, where in this episode, we are going to be using this, the Smart 4-2, because I still need to do the City Car Open, I think it's called. Yeah, City Car Open, and might as well get it done early, so we're going to go ahead and use the Smart 4-2, because it's about the most interesting car that's available to do this. And of course, I have to put a body kit on it. Are you kidding me? We're gonna put this, yeah, like, well, and we're gonna make it a race car. What in the hell is that rear bumper? It doesn't even have an exhaust. This one changes the, oh, it's wide body. Look at that. Kind of. It changes a little bit of it, something. This is probably the dumbest car I'm going to use during this entire series. And of course we gotta turbocharge it. Who needs power, or who needs handling upgrades when you can just have a shit ton of power? That's my plan. So when you get up to F200, there we go, perfect. That's all we're gonna do, nothing else. Just full power in the Smart 4-2. Oh, this is gonna go bad so quickly. Oh my god. But, let's go ahead and get into this. So we have Ladera, Short, Sedona Club, Sunset Club, Maple Valley, Short Circuit Reverse, and Hockenheim Short. Let's go! Alrighty, so we're here. I'll have a look at the Twitter, or the... I just posted something on Twitter, so it's on my mind. The car list, there we go. You've seen it. Oh no. Oh no! Oh no! Are you kidding me right now? Ah, you fucking piece of garbage smart car. Everybody's finished already. Oh, there is another smart car in this. Okay, never mind. I just didn't see it. I despise the smart car. Smart fan. Not really. Oh, I didn't even get... You know what? We're going to go back into this. Because I didn't even get an award for it. We're just going to put the difficulty down to hard again. Because, you know, even though I was saying how I wasn't going to, you know. Okay, difficulty. Sorry to all you hardcore people who are going to be like, oh, professional. I don't care. I really don't. I just want to play through a game and record videos of it. I don't give a shit about being the best or anything. Okay. Hello, smart car again. You sucked the first time. You're probably going to suck again. I'm gonna do this view first because, yeah. I just realized the other smart car is right in front of me. How did I not notice that earlier? Later, everybody! Drag race. At least when you spin around in this car, it's like easy to get it pointing the right direction again because it's such short wheelbase. But then again, it's also very hard to keep it from spinning once you're sliding. So, I don't know. Okay, this is being a lot. Oh god. But a lot more biased towards me now. Fucking goddamn it. I have to redo a race in a smart car. Of all cars, the first race I have to redo is in a smart car. That's what happens when you don't give a fuck, kids. That's just what happens. This car has such a simple interior. It has one gauge, which is a speedometer. It has a digital display down below that shows the gear I'm in. I can see that much. Are you kidding me right now? You cock wagon. This car is now called the cock wagon. I like how hood view isn't even hood view because there is no hood to view from. Like, there's nothing here. Oh, there you can see a little bit of it when you look to the side. Why must I suck at driving the smart car of all cars? Oh god. Alright, I'm catching up. I'll be up close to him in a second here. Hopefully. Should be. Make the turn, little smart car. Oh my god, I barely made it. Kind of surprised I didn't smack into the wall there. Come on, you have a turbocharger. Fucking use it to your advantage. Okay, there we go. I'll just use curbs to my advantage. Oh, jeez. No. Oh, smart car. God, this thing is so easy to, like, just lose all of your momentum with. And then it's like, it takes forever to get it back. Okay. We won that time. I almost didn't win, but somehow I managed to do it. Let's have a look at the race results again. Since they're more in my favor this time around. And let's fucking go. Got some more credits, got some more affinity XP and shit. Alright, on our second roast. We are on Sedona Club, so yay. This car does get a lot of traction off the line at least. So that's nice. Has a decent amount of torque to back it up as well. 2 laps on this track. I mean, it handles fairly well, it's just as soon as you get sliding, it's like... done. You're done for. Because either A, you lose all your momentum during the slide, because you're trying to make it not slide, so you're like not trying to go whatsoever like that. Or you spin out. And that's your two options you get with this car. What an interesting little vehicle. There's a lot of counter-steering going on with this car. Hey, the Citroen or something is in second, I think. Unless it's a different color of the car that was in second last time. Ah! Yeah, it's extremely easy to overcorrect yourself as well. Ah, there's a Peugeot. Yeah, it's the same car. Peugeot, or however the frick you say it. The frickety frack. Okay, make sure I slow down here because this corner is a pain in the balls. Hey, you guys are fucking just cruising on along with easy mode because you have front wheel drive. Except for the other smart car, which he doesn't have a probably 120 horsepower, whatever the hell this thing has. So he's probably doing okay, not gonna lie. Oh, look at that speedometer. Where is the needle going? I don't think it's attached down there. It might be, I don't know. Because I'm pretty sure it's like where that little hump is at the bottom of the needle right now. Pretty sure that's like its pivot point. So therefore going like 100 is really messing with it. This isn't Forza 3 where I remember in I had a 79 Chevy Camaro with way too much power and I took it around a circle and the speedometer, like, by the time I was going like 60 or 70 miles per hour, the speedometer was fully topped out at like 120 or however high it went. It's like, what are you doing? Look at that big dial in the center. What is that for? Is that... that's probably like the fan speed for the climate control or something. Something fucking silly like that. Just need a gigantic knob for it. Because this car is a gigantic knob. Haha, British jokes. I'm so funny. Alrighty. And cross the line with a little bit more success than the last time around. I don't think anybody got my meme on Twitter because nobody said anything about it yet. And generally they do. Alright, everybody's finished. Let's continue our asses on. Level 2 was smart. Because we are smart. Okay, on to our third race at Sunset Peninsula Club. Normal way around, so we're going to be hitting turns right away. But I think I'll be able to win this one fairly easily. Because if you know, lots of power in the small smart car, plus half an oval, equals big fast. Also, I will confirm my theory that the speedometer is messed up. Because I'll probably be going a lot over... or way over 100 miles per hour by the time I get to the finish line there. Each lap. There was only 2 laps. Huh. Ah. Yeah, fun fact. This game has really short races, except for if you, like, do the World Tour Series or whatever. Not even World Tour. I think World Tour is the thing that, like, season play in Forza 3, I think. But like the I guess championship races, the very last ones, like the last 6 or 7 things towards the right of the events list, there we go. I think those are fairly long races, and quite a few races at that. For sure the World Series actually has like 12 races, if I remember right. 12 races per thing. I don't know what it's called. My English is bad. Can I see the speedometer, please? Oh, I'm hit 100. Yeah, the speedometer gets pegged on cars in this game at 100. Kind of makes me sad, because like, in Test Drive Unlimited, they didn't have pegs. Or they weren't pegged, I guess. So therefore, I'm pretty sure I got the Mustang GT up to like 170 or so with upgrades. And like, the speedometer had made almost a complete circle. Like, my truck doesn't have a, my Ford Ranger doesn't have a peg to stop it from going over 120. But my Ranger also doesn't go over 120, so, you know, I guess that's not a bad thing, per se. But fun fact, I did actually break the speed limiter on my truck. It no longer limits the speed to 92 miles per hour. Don't ask me why or how, but it, or how I know, but it doesn't. And I'm 99% sure that I broke it after, doing some in-depth testing. Oh, I forgot I didn't even change views. Oh well. Here, you can look at the outside of the... I picked the ugliest color combination that they had available for this thing from the factory. Look at its wide body! What even is this car? It's got like a wide body kit, it's got a silver thing that looks like it's supposed to be, or trying to be an Audi R8. Oh, what even are you, Mr. Smart Car? All right, that was a quick race. I can't say I'm like enjoying driving this car or not enjoying it. Like, it's not really whatever. It's more towards not liking it, but it's not like extremely bad. If you know what I'm saying, I probably don't, because I'm bad at saying things. All right, here we are on our second to last race at Maple Valley. Hopefully this will go well. I doubt it, but hopefully. This car doesn't have a speedometer either. I'm not sure I'm a fan of that. Did I say speedometer? I meant tachometer. This car doesn't have a speedometer. Wow, what am I on? So later, literally everybody. Just pass them all directly off the bat. Yep, there we go. Oh, already. It's already happening. Uh-oh. Well, we have 2 laps to fix this. What the hell are you? Excuse me. Is that a Toyota? Oh, no. I'm just gonna go ahead and restart that, because that was just all kinds of bad. I am the bad. Of course, this is the first car I've had to actually, like, retry races in. And I guess I can't really be angry, because I could have upgraded handling, but I didn't. So therefore, I am the pleb. It fucking backfired, are you kidding me? Oh my god, oh, for freaking frick's sake. I've already done goofed it, and it's the first turn, well, second turn. God damn it. Oh, don't let off the gas, that's your only mistake. Hitting the gas actually helps in this car, because, you know, mid-engine. And also such a short fucking wheelbase. Okay, careful. Drive off the road there a little bit, don't even care. I'm distancing myself from, like, 3rd through 8th place, along with this Citroen. I just noticed the little vents for the engine in the back bumper. Just why? I mean, I could see why, but like, I don't know. This car is just a bundle of what the fuck is going on. Change that real quick, even though it was like a little bit late. But we got a whole extra lap to go, so. Hey, that is the, it's not the fan speed in the center, it's the zones for the AC and climate control. I see defrost on the top. I can't see any other ones. Oh, there's... I think feed is to the left. And then I'm assuming that, face vents are on the right, even though I can't see them, especially now because everything's black. Also, fun fact, I can't figure out how to change the contrast settings on my monitor, so therefore everything's going to stay dark. Which I've been really struggling with recently. Both this game, Ford Racing 3, Gran Turismo 5. Oh, Gran Turismo actually isn't bad. This game is really bad for some reason. Like, the contrasting on the interior is just really, really bad. I don't know why. Although I've been playing Gran Turismo in cockpit view because I've been driving mostly standard cars. I don't know. Anyways, I won. Somehow. Why do I say somehow? Like, I know why I won. It's because it's not on professional difficulty, and my car is slightly better than everybody else's. I did get the best lap. Hell yeah, boy. Let's go. I got money and XP and more money. And performance parts are 75% off because I'm totally going to buy another smart car and upgrade it for free. Yes, game. Thank you for letting me know. Okay. We're here on Hockenheim. Short time to die, probably, because this track has a lot of sharp turns. And I can assume I'm going to spin out at least once. If not twice, or three times, or 10 times. Alright, let's fucking go. We got 2 laps. I'm fucking ready-ish. Power through the corner. Ah, balls in my face already. There's fucking paddle shifters on this car, I just realized that. Because I haven't been paying attention to the driver's hands. Whenever he shifts, you can see... Why aren't you using the paddle shifters, you dingus? You can see the fucking left one right there. It's got the little minus on it. What the hell even is this car? Why does it have paddle shifters? Why does a smart car have paddle shifters? Unless those aren't paddle shifters, I'm stupid. Which is quite a high possibility, but still, like... Well, there's definitely paddle shifters. There's nothing else. There's a minus on one side and a plus on the other. There's nothing else they could be. Don't tell me they're radio controls, because I'm not going to believe that shit. Oh, that's turning your volume up and down. No, it isn't. It's fucking paddle shifters on a smart car. I think I'm going to be glad when this episode is over. I'm going to be done driving this car forever. Okay, let's get the hell out of the interior of this thing. Look at its little vents. Where is it? Where is the exhaust? Oh, is that the exhaust on the right there? Like, I see one little tiny dot, and I'm sure it's... I'm thinking you can't see it now, but I thought it was a reflection of the exhaust. But who really knows? Because I didn't see any exhaust whenever I upgraded this car. I could see exhaust in the other one because they came out the middle. Center exit exhaust, because why not? I kind of want to do center exit exhaust in my truck. Because A, I'm never going to have a trailer hitch on it to tow anything with because it's a fucking 4-cylinder. And it's also a Ranger. And B, because it looks cool. Like, I kind of want to just modify something up. Just one single exhaust pipe, like a BMW. Kind of offset it to the right side a little bit. Fuck yeah. Because there it comes out the right, the passenger side of the truck anyways. So all I have to do is just kind of extend it a little bit, bend some pipes, and voila. Or I'd have to make it go around the spare tire somehow. Or I could just put the spare tire in the bed and get a tonneau cover, which I also don't want to do. I don't know. Either way, it's going to be stupid. No matter what I do, no matter if I do a side exit like I've wanted to do, aka a side exit that goes out in front of the right or the right rear wheel, or if I do a center exit, it's going to look stupid no matter what. There's our last race done. Thank God. Get me out of this goddamn smart car. Alrighty. Got some more credits. Didn't quite level up to full 4. Like I give a fuck. Honestly. And we have the most boring race series done. Well, I guess it wasn't really boring, but what would seem like the most boring to me. So anyways, thank you all for watching this episode of Forza 4, and I'm out of here. See ya.